A warm welcome to you, and thank you for joining us on The Morning Call. Now, after millions of people cast their ballots in Wednesday's presidential election in Madagascar, counting is underway. According to the country's electoral commission, the SINAI, turnout was around 40%. Provisional results are expected by November 20, which must then be confirmed by the High Constitutional Court by November 28.
We are now joined by our correspondent Volana Razafi Manansoa to discuss this election and the ongoing counting of the ballots.
On va passer pour l'instant au Journal de l'Afrique. Apparemment, on a la correspondante. Allô, Volana?
Hello, Volana.
Allô, oui, bonjour.
Bonjour, Volana.
Alors,
so how is the counting process being carried out and what are the first estimates? With a provisional participation rate of 47%, the two leading candidates of the first round are André Rajoelina with 43% of the votes and Marc Ravalomanana with 42% of the votes. An announcement without real surprise. The two former presidents were largely the favorites in this election. So these are provisional results for the moment. And as I speak, we have the results of 131 polling stations out of the 24,852 polling stations. These results were collected from the scanned and electronic versions of the minutes and are being distributed as they are released. So how exactly does it work? After the counting of the ballots of the 24,852 polling stations, the minutes of each, the results of each polling station are scanned and the data are transcribed electronically. These results are then centralized first at the level of the 119 districts and then sent via a secure internet connection to the headquarters of the National Independent Electoral Commission in Antananarivo. The commission checks, then compares the scanned versions with the computer transcripts and notes observations and anomalies before broadcasting them live. According to this election, according to the election body, publishing the results as they are published allows for greater transparency. And in parallel, each of the favorites for the election had assessors in the polling stations and were also able to centralize their own results. The communication team of Marc Ravalomanana thus published before the commission its own results, as well as in social media networks like in Facebook. But according to the law, only the statement based on the paper is authentic. They will be processed by the Election Commission and the High Constitutional Court in the coming days. So the final results must be published by 28th of November. And André Rajoelina and Marc Ravalomanana are therefore the two leading candidates and who could therefore find themselves in the second round. What is the reaction in their respective camps?
At
the outset, I would like to point out that these elections were generally conducted in a calm atmosphere without any major incidents. Many Malagasy people feared excesses or even the return of a crisis, because here no one has forgotten the political crisis of 2009 between Rajoelina and Ravalomanana, which led to his exile and caused the death of dozens of demonstrators. The international community had described Rajoelina's takeover as a coup d'etat, so even though supporters of both clans had been waiting for this duel for more than 5 years. Remember that neither Marc Ravalomanana nor André Rajoelina had been allowed to run in 2013. The population was afraid to relive the traumatic clashes of 2009. So it was a calm election and accounting and jubilation for the supporters of Ravalomanana and Rajoelina. And in his headquarters, former president and candidate Marc Ravalomanana, nicknamed Dada, which means dad, repeated to his supporters who came to a claim him, and I quote, "Dada is elected." His campaign coordinator also told the national television, and I quote, "There's a second round and our candidate is in second place in the current result." Already when I was at the polling station at Rabea Rivelo High School in downtown Antananarivo, the atmosphere was electric. At each announcement of number 25, the number of Marc Ravalomanana, the crowd applauded, shouted with joy, while when number 13 came out of the box, the number of André Rajoelina, the supporters of Ravalomanana booed. The same joyful atmosphere in the city of Toamasina in the east of the Great Island, where a fellow journalist told me that cries of joy resounded in the polling station where she was, with each ballot for Ravalomanana and Rajoelina. And what future do the other candidates have now, Volana? Already throughout the camp, Rajoelina, nicknamed Zandri Kelly, which means little brother, was perceived as a danger by the other candidates. Some decided to form an alliance as early as the campaign period. A few days ago, a presidential candidate, Saraha Georgette, withdrew and announced her support for Rajoelina. Others seem to have moved towards everything but Rajoelina. An interesting anecdote, the two former presidents, Marc Ravalomanana and Harry Rajaonarimampianina, Pianina, had both denounced in interviews the debauchery of means used by Rajoelina to campaign, while they themselves were accused of having used astronomical means for their own campaign. Rajoelina seemed to be the man to kill. And before the end of the campaign on Monday evening, when we asked Harry Rajaonarimampianina what he thought of a political alliance with one of his opponents, he did not categorically refuse, but remained evasive by saying that alliances are made and broken. And last night, Marc Ravalomanana also said, and I quote, "I propose to work with all the candidates who have applied. The wars should be over. We should all work together from now on. And in the next few days, we will know if the remaining candidates will join forces with Daddy Ravalomanana or little brother Rajoelina."